Hi, if you're someone who easily gives up in the times of opposition, or someone who is hesitant to take a bold step when it is needed, or someone who hasn't really experienced what the strength of God can do in our life, stay on with me today as we talk about a Bible character who, with the presence of God, did something that was needed for his people in today's Bible Banter. Welcome back once again for today's Bible Banter. Like every week, we are here today at a different place. Well, the weather today is not really supportive, so I'm not sure if I would be able to finish my video at this place, but at least I've started, and the rain has started. Well, last week when we shot a video, we were at Manham Fields, and I was sure that people would know that, and someone predicted what my next stop would be, so I thought of going on a different path, and that's why I am here today. I don't know if many of us would be able to identify the bridge that's along the canal or that's across the canal. Well, there are so many bridges across the canal. If you can identify this bridge, would be a great deal. And let me know if this helps to identify bridges like this. Well, as I said, today we are going to talk about a Bible character that did exactly what was needed to do to help his people in times of trouble. The Bible character that we are going to discuss today is of Nehemiah. Now, Nehemiah, the book of Nehemiah starts with a visitor visiting Nehemiah, and that visitor talks about a situation of the city of Jerusalem to Nehemiah. When Nehemiah hears about this situation, he was completely shattered, and he ends up crying and spending time with the Lord. After few days, as he goes on to do his duties in the presence of king looked at him and thought something is not really right with Nehemiah today. Now let me tell you that it was not really expected of people, those who were in king's service, to have a sad face in front of king. They were supposed to be always smiling. So Nehemiah going in front of king like this was not really something helpful for him. But then king looked at him and king asked him, what's the matter? Looking at this opportunity, Nehemiah thought, I should talk to king about my situation. So Nehemiah described about Jerusalem and told him the poor situation that people are living in. When king heard this, king not only gave Nehemiah permission to go to Jerusalem and rebuild his city, but also provided him things that he would need. Now, Nehemiah was a man who had a foresight. So he also got a letter from king for governors who were ruling on regions surrounding Jerusalem. So with all these things, Nehemiah went to the city of Jerusalem. When Nehemiah reached the city of Jerusalem, he looked around the city. He did his survey. He observed things that are needed to be done. And the priority for him remained building of the walls of the city. So Nehemiah is one of those characters in Bible who is known for his leadership skills in terms of strategically planning what was needed to be done. So Nehemiah made a group of people and divided different sections of wall to different groups. And it is said that every one was responsible for the wall which is very close to their house. And the work of building of the city, or the walls of the city, began. But then the path never always remains simple. There was opposition. Jerusalem was surrounded by different regions, and these regions were ruled by different governors assigned by the king of Persia. Now, Jerusalem was a key city in that region, and few of these governors wanted Jerusalem under their rule. But Nehemiah, being there on king's special order, would have taken away their desire to rule or to have control over Jerusalem. So they started troubling Nehemiah, and they started threatening him. They started making every plan possible to make sure that his plan does not go ahead. But that did not really move Nehemiah from his focus. Looking at this threat, Nehemiah divided his people in two teams. So when one team was working on the construction work or rebuilding of the wall, there was this other team who was with their weapons always on alert to make sure that the work that they're doing would not be distracted. Not only that, Nehemiah also made sure that every person would carry their weapon wherever they go, just in case they came across their enemies. Bible says even when they went to drink water, they were supposed to take their weapons with them just to make sure that they're strong enough and they can face anybody who comes in their way. Well, even as this situation was going on, there was another issue that Nehemiah had to face. Now, there were a part of Jewish people who came to Nehemiah who were from a poorer section of a society or poorer families, describing about their bad situation or economically poor situation to Nehemiah. In order to get food and other necessary things for their life, they had mortgaged their land to richer brothers in the society, and then they had taken their money. And since they could not return their money, they had taken up their children as their slaves. When Nehemiah heard this, he gathered the whole Jewish community together and he described the whole situation. And he asked the richer Jews to return the land or any money that they own to this poorer community so that all would have food to eat and a place to sleep. Well, the opposition did not just stop there. They always threatened them. But now they went a step further and they started making a false accusation to Nehemiah. In fact, one of the governors wrote back to Nehemiah saying that if you don't give up to our demands, I will write to king stating that you are trying to rule the city of Jerusalem. Now, if this word goes to king, it would have been a big threat to Nehemiah. But then he did not move from his intention. He wrote back saying that it really doesn't make matters to me because king knows that I'm not ruling. And he asked God for his strength. He asked God for his guidance. And with his guidance and with his strength, Nehemiah continued to work harder and harder. And he could fulfill the plan. He could achieve the aim that he came to Jerusalem for. Well, after that, in the book of Nehemiah, we also see Ezra. Well, I'm not going to talk about Ezra, but then both Nehemiah and Ezra worked together. So Nehemiah not only rebuilt the city, but he also worked on rebuilding the lives of people of Jerusalem. Now, for various reasons, these people have gone astray from God. And they have started mixing up with other people. So Nehemiah gathered all the people and gave them a call of returning back to purity, returning back on focusing on God, returning back to serving God in a way that was expected of them. So what is that we learn from the story of Nehemiah? Well, first and the most important thing, be bold in God's company. Nehemiah was in the presence of king, but he knew that Almighty God is with him. So he did not fear. He did not think twice, but he prayed and did what was needed. And he spoke with king. Nehemiah was a man of prayer. Now, if you read the story of Nehemiah in the Bible, it is whenever he faced a difficult situation, it is said in the Bible, he asked God or he prayed to God. How many times in our life, when we face situations, do we pray, my friends? Nehemiah did not give up easily, even when he was under tremendous pressure. He also faced a life threat. But Nehemiah did not give up from what he intended to do because he knew that his God is with him. My friends, at times in our life, we are so scared of our life that we make God secondary and move on with our own lives. Nehemiah was a thoughtful leader. When he saw that there is a section of his people who are suffering, he did not ignore them, but he made sure that their needs are fulfilled so that they can become stronger and equal part in the aim that he had. Nehemiah was fearful while serving to God. So when he saw people are not living their life the way they're supposed to live, he did not keep quiet or he did not ignore their lives, thinking, if I do this, they might not really help me in my work. But Nehemiah showed them their mistakes. Ask them to rectify their mistakes. They rectify their wrongdoings and be focused on God. And the most important thing about Nehemiah is he did what was needed to be done. My friends, I hope as we have heard about the story of Nehemiah, we would do what is needed to be done in our community, in our church, in our family, and we would take the bold steps that we should be taking in and with the Lord. In my last video, I asked you two questions. The first question was, how many times does the name of God appear in the book of Esther? Well, the name of God does not appear, or there is no mention of God, the word God, in the book of Esther. Now, that really makes a lot of people wonder, why is that then this book is involved in the Bible? Or why is this book in the Bible then? Because it doesn't talk about God. But my friends, in a very real sense, that's how God works with us. We at times do not see God in our lives, even when He is there. We do not acknowledge God, even when He does a lot of things in our life. God was always working with Esther in what she was doing for him, for her people. In the same way, God works in our lives. Second question was, what is the meaning of the name Esther? Esther means star. Now, before coming into the court, being involved in the process of becoming queen, Esther was known as Hadassah. Now, she had to change this name because Mordecai did not want her to reveal her identity as a Jewish person. Well, that brings me to today's questions. Who were two other people who brought people from the kingdom of Persia to the city of Jerusalem before Nehemiah? Let me tell you, Nehemiah was the third person to do this. There were two other people who brought two different groups to Jerusalem. That scared me. Nehemiah was the third person to do this. There were two other people who did this. Who are they? Second question, chronologically speaking, which is the last book of the Old Testament? Historically, event-wise, which is the last book of Old Testament? I hope today's Bible Banter was a blessing to you all. And if you have enjoyed this, please let us know in comments below. If you want any more additions or any changes, please let us know that. So we would continue to make changes that we would be a blessing to you through these videos. Thank you. Have a lovely week, guys.